Welcome to Make the Cut Classroom. I'm Rob, and I hope you're ready for part two of this print and cut series. Okay, so this is just a continuation of the print and cut series with Make the Cut software. And in this tutorial, we're going to be cutting with the Black Cat Cougar using the three-point registration that we got from Make the Cut. Now, our laser is already calibrated, and you will also need a calibrated laser in order to do a three-point registration mark print and cut. Now, we left off last time where the paper's coming out of the printer, so we're just going to go ahead and place that on our mat, and we're going to lay the paper on the mat just like you see it on the computer screen. You know, so the best way to do this is make sure that that feeder arrow is facing to the left like we had it on the screen. Now, we're going to go ahead and lay the paper on, and I'm just going to secure it with this roller. Now, we're not going to go over how to load this into the machine. I think we all know how to do that. And I'm just going to go ahead and secure it, and I'm going to have the origin set to the bottom right of the paper. All right, next we need to go back into Make the Cut software because we are ready to cut. Now, right before we go back to Make the Cut, let's go ahead and make sure that we have the Cougar in the online mode by pushing the online button. All right, so we're going to be using the CanK plugin in order to do this print and cut. Now, if you don't have the Click and Cut plugin, you can go ahead and download that from the Make the Cut website, and I'll put a link in the description box. All right, so we're going to go ahead and go up to Cut Project With, and we're going to go ahead and select the K&K series. Now, once you do that, a new window will appear, and we want to make sure that we have the K&K Max selected, and the connection speed needs to be the 3800, and we're going to go ahead and leave the force and speed alone unchecked. And you want to make sure that we have the print and cut selected. Now, once you have all that, you can go ahead and hit the start button. Okay, and we're almost done, I promise. Now, once you do that, a new window will appear, and it's just going to be asking you the length. I'm going to go ahead and plug an 8.5 in here because we have an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Now, once we hit the begin button, you'll notice that your mat will move, and it will move approximately 8.5 inches. And that will get us close enough to the first registration mark so that we can go ahead and move our laser to that first registration point that it's wanting. Now, a couple things you'll want to notice here in this new menu is that you have this little blinking red dot. Now, that blinking red dot lets you know, hey, that's the registration mark that it is looking for. And we need to move our laser so it's right over that dot. Now, the magnitude of the movement of laser is determined by the Move By drop-down menu right here. Now, right now I have it set to 1 over 128, which is 1 over 128, and that's how far it's going to move every time I hit that arrow. So it's going to move 1/28 of an inch every time I touch an arrow button. Now, here's a pro tip for you. You can hold the Control button down and use your arrows on your keyboard, and this will allow it to move 1/8 of an inch. So that way, if you have a large distance to cover, you can go ahead and hold the Control button down and push an arrow key that's on your keyboard. And when you get close to the registration mark, you can let go of the Control button and it will move the distance of whatever is inside that Move By drop-down menu. So I keep it at 1/28 and I use the keyboard. And if I need to move it a large distance, I hold the Control button down and use the arrows. And once I get close, I go ahead and release that Control button and I move it. All right, so when you move the laser over the registration dot, you will notice that once you're on top of it, you'll see the dot dim. Now, once you have it in place, right where you want it, right where that dim is, you go ahead and hit the Enter button on the keyboard, or the origin key that is displayed on your screen right there. Now, we're just going to go ahead and do this two more times. As you can see, it will move to where it thinks that registration mark is, and it'll get close, and that way you can tweak it with the arrow buttons and hit the Enter button, and it's just going to look for three dots, and that is all. So once you're over that last dot and you push the Enter button, Make the Cut's going to start sending all that data to your machine, and it will start cutting. Now, I'm not going to bore you with you watching this machine cut. Let's go ahead and check out the final results. Now, as you can see, as I'm peeling the paper off, you can see that the print and cut turned out very nicely, and you can do all this with a three-point registration mark and a laser-calibrated machine. Now, I also wanted to point out to you that it does not matter how you align your paper up. As you can see, I'm laying this paper totally crooked, and I'm going to go ahead and stick it in the machine. I'm going to find those three registration dots, and let's go ahead and see how it cuts around these konnichiwa dots. Now, as you can see, it takes a little more time finding those dots because Make the Cut assumes that you lay the paper straight. But after you find the second dot, the third dot, it pretty much gets it right on. And this will show you that it doesn't matter how you can lay the paper down on your mat, that it will still conduct a nice print and cut. So with that, I'm Rob with ScrappyDew.com, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you.